I'm Dr. Rashmi Yogesh, consultant fertility specialist, an endocrinologist, an entrepreneur, an influencer, a maestro in handling cases of recurrent pregnancy losses and recurrent implantation failures, with special interest in reproductive endocrinology, regenerative medicines, genetic and immunology. I am the founder, clinical director of an upcoming group of fertility centers and a mother, a blessed mother of two. When I say mother, the word mother comes with an extra weightage. It gathers more respect and emotion. I'm sure all of you will agree with me. Maternal bliss is something not everybody has. For some people, it comes as a natural flow of life, a breeze. For others, it is a struggle. It's a journey of heartbreaks. It's a journey of unwavering resilience to never give up. However, a woman puts in her mind, body, and soul into achieving pregnancy when she really wants to do it. Some of them are successful, and they get into the bliss of motherhood, whereas there are other women who get in setbacks. I call these as healings. These are opportunities to heal one's soul and call this the healing and new beginnings in life, because there are several other arenas to life and not just giving birth to a child. So here, let's embark on this journey of the miracle of motherhood and the healing of new beginnings. I was born as a sixth child to my mother, Dr. Annapurna, who is now 88 years old and has been an obstetrician delivering thousands of children all her life. She got married at the age of 18. She had passed a 12th standard, and she was somebody who had a state rank in her hand and was awarded with a merit medical seat in the prestigious Grants Medical College, Mumbai. It was in 1956. She came from a family of philanthropists where education was given the utmost importance. She managed to convince my father and the family she got married into and decided to pursue her MBBS in 1956. Going out of the house those days was not all that easy, but she did it. But life is not all that easy, always. She was asked to discontinue her education after 3 months and come home. She was given the ordeal of the prime responsibility of women those days, giving birth to children. She took this up as a challenge, restarted her education by taking up her MBBS in Usmania Medical College, Hyderabad, and went on to complete her education while she also did her family responsibilities. She had her first child during her first phase of MBBS, second child during her second phase of MBBS, and third child during her internship. She continued to do her responsibilities. Her pregnancies, her deliveries were not all that easy. The first time she developed something called as eclampsia, that is fits because of hypertension in pregnancy, because it was obviously a teenage pregnancy. Second time she developed deep vein thrombosis of the leg, blue leg, due to a retained placenta. Third time she developed PPH, postpartum hemorrhage, because of heavy bleeding during delivery. But still, she continued to have all the three children. So there must be something magical in the word motherhood, isn't it? After this, she pursued her further education in obstetrics gynecology, came back to her hometown, and started a 30-bedded maternity home, one of its kind, in a small place in North Karnataka, and get all that she really wanted to in her life. It was like a dream come true seeing her 30-bedded, 5-floored nursing home stand right in front of her eyes. You would call her successful at this point in time, isn't it? But no, societal pressures made her feel she wasn't, because all the three children she'd given birth to were daughters. And so she went on, as she climbed the ladder of success in her life, to have the fourth child, which was again a daughter, and a fifth child, which was a son. And finally, after 6 years, she gave birth to her sixth child, and that was me. Imagine, this was the kind of impact of a woman going through motherhood those days, but there is some energy women have, isn't it, to be able to do all of this? Well, my birth was again amidst whispers of, oh, it's a girl again. But my mother saw me as a ray of hope for my eldest sister, Dr. Uma, who had entered into wedlock in a consanguineous marriage and was having repeated pregnancy losses and was childless. Probably she saw me as a ray of hope and that's why called me Rashmi. However, my eldest sister became my foster mother. As all of us were living together, I had the privilege of two mothers. But a lady has it deep in her heart to have her own child. My sister was no different. With me in her arms, she went on struggling to have her own child. There were countless journeys in trains and flights to renowned doctors all over India. There were countless visits to fertility centers, and I witnessed all of them. The first thing in my memory lane that flashes onto me is the glimpse of the waiting lounges of fertility clinics. I cannot forget women who are yearning to get pregnant sit silently thinking all up to themselves. The glistening tears in the eyes of those women who would give a smile to me as a toddler. I cannot forget the loud cries of women and the silent sobs of women who came out of the doctor's clinic with a negative report after having tried desperately for a pregnancy. These had an impact on my mind and soul, and that's the reason why I made up my mind to be the torchbearer for these women who are yearning to get pregnant. I went on to study more and more. It was not just to get in academic excellence, but to pursue my dream of becoming a fertility specialist. And here, today, if I spend more time in the consultation room of a fertility center rather than in the family room, it is because of the impact all these women have had in my life. The clouds of these memories that clog my mind and heart tell me that I have the important responsibility of working for the cause of these women. Fortunately, I've been able to do it thanks to the support of my entire family. However, when I went on to witness so much in my life, I also saw caterpillaring of agony with my sister's recurrent pregnancy loss, and that's why I went on to read more and more about recurrent pregnancy losses and recurrent implantation failure, and I have kind of mastered the art of making sure I help every lady who has recurrent pregnancy loss get on to the stepper of motherhood. However, this is not all. I saw my sister giving birth to a child and saw so much of happiness with the birth of the child. And then I realized that motherhood is a miracle. I cannot end without telling that my mother, who went through all these pregnancies so supernaturally, had also got to see in her life the death of her three daughters right in front of her eyes. My mother, an epitome of courage and resilience, taught me that the major setbacks in life should not be taken as step downs. These are areas where one can heal the soul and look at life in a new perspective. And therefore, I call these as healing through new beginnings. Life can be long or short, happy or sad. Life can get in a lot of competitions, a lot of successes and failures, but living, striving, and thriving with happiness is what is the essence of life. Well, with this, I told you about the miracle of motherhood, and also I spoke to you about what healing of new beginnings is. But I cannot forget to tell the crux of this, that is the emotions a woman goes through when she is trying to get pregnant. A woman has silent moments. The silent moments between a husband and wife who are married speaks volumes about the kind of pain they are going through. The rustle of people speaking behind their backs of they being childless is a major heart-aching situation that they go through. The most difficult state of life is when physical intimacy becomes an exercise rather than pleasure. It's not just that women avoid going to social gatherings when they are in this phase of life and they just cannot enjoy anything in life. Pregnancy becomes the utmost USP of their life. And I also see a lot of women who come to the fertility center cry on my shoulders and tell, "Doctor, when so many women can get pregnant with pleasure, why do I have to go through so much pain?" I tell them that this is a true testament of womanhood. Be strong, and when victory comes, you will be the winner. However, with all the support I give and millions of people around the lady give, the most important thing for a woman is having her man next to her. It makes a world of difference. However, there are some women who are not privileged to have their life partner to support them. I see that a lot of women struggle all by themselves to have a child, and this journey gets even more difficult. Hey, young men, one message to all of you. When you marry a lady, see her as an individual. Don't go back counting flaws on her and treat her as daughter of a family who probably nurtured her less perfectly. No, once you select a flower, the flower is all yours. You don't really have to go back and check how the plant looked like, how the roots looked like, and the soil looked like, and where the plant grew. It's your flower, it's all yours. You don't have to look back. Treat a woman with grace, treat a woman with love, and you know, motherhood and the journey towards motherhood becomes much more easier. This is a message I would like to give to all young men. This is the time for transformation. Unfortunately, even today, in a lot of Indian families, women are treated as daughters of a particular family and not their own. This is something that we really have to transform. However, I call myself passionate about two things. One is to help women achieve their dream of parenthood, and second, to kindle the sparkle of companionship between soulmates, which I call the essence of life. It's not just about having children. It is about enjoying marital bliss and companionship. And if this is portrayed first, I think the pressure of having a child will not take away the life of so many women that is happening today. Pregnancy is something which is required, but men, please don't make pregnancy the motto of marriage. Companionship and good relationship should be the motto of marriage. What I agree is that if there is true love, all egos and misunderstandings can be abolished, and therefore the divorce rates that are there in today's world can be brought down significantly. Today, I see that women have a lot to achieve in their life. I would want to tell a bit of my story here. I have to tell you about myself. I went on to do my MBBS, and I was able to do really well in all the years of the medical education. I was able to get a free medical seat, but I was unsuccessful in getting a free post-graduation seat because there was a medical illness that made me difficult to sit and study for long hours. I was diagnosed with tuberculosis of the spine, and I was told by a neurosurgeon that the tingling and numbness in my fingers and the toes were all probably because of a huge abscess that was there in the back. And he said, if it is not the right diagnosis, you could be bound to wheelchair all your life. This was something that made me feel never desperate. I felt even if I'm bound to a wheelchair, there's one task I can always do, and that is counseling women who are struggling to get pregnant and give them the ordeal to fight it out. I feel when destiny gets us difficult situations, some people get us down in life, I feel women should feel that when people bury us, we should tell them that, hey you, we are seeds. If you bury, we'll grow up as plants. And that's how a resilience of every woman should be to fight out things in life. Despite having this debilitating problem, I was able to go forward with my internship of medical education. And then, after having done that, I also continued taking the tuberculosis drugs for 9 months. After finishing my post-graduation in OBG, I also got the opportunity to do a fellowship in reproductive medicine. Marriage came in the way, but it was never an obstacle. I'm fortunate to find a life partner who is an orthopedic surgeon who accepted all the odds in me despite knowing that tuberculosis of the spine can be a hindrance to pregnancy. However, I was blessed to have a son very soon after marriage. And after marriage, with the help of the family I had, I was able to do my fellowship in reproductive medicine. Soon after, corporate world welcomed me with a job. I had everything, name, fame, money, but I was still not very happy. I wanted to do something really great. So I wanted to soar high with my wings and start my own fertility center where I can have pregnancies and happiness created with love. And so I started off the journey, but then my second pregnancy came in the way. However, in the 9 months of my pregnancy, I continued to make my fertility center. And yes, my daughter and my fertility center took birth at the same time. 2018 was marvelous. And these 6 years, I've traveled this journey in a very, very fruitful way. And today, I am here in front of all of you because of the strength womanhood has given me, because of the strength my life partner and my family has given me. So let us all decide to walk forwards in life with the strength that we have. Never give up in life, and women, never feel that you cannot achieve what you really want to. With the advent of technology, motherhood is now a possibility for every woman out here, and I'm sure the miracle of motherhood will happen to every woman who is yearning to become pregnant in the coming years with recent advances in the field of reproductive medicine. Thank you all. Dr. Rashmi Yogesh signing off.